This is Frank the Tank from Upgrade.
Once you find the center screw in here, the whole motherboard locks in automatically, and then you can commence to start adding your screws in every single corner. Very simple to install on this Corsair tower. Everything seems to fit perfectly fine, even on the side bracket. So fan-wise, I would probably remove this one if you have any issues trying to install a motherboard on this system. I would probably remove it. My suggestion is probably have Corsair not add this fan, have it separate in here, and then add it yourself, because it did get in the way of setting up the motherboard in here. So not bad fit. Fits perfect. Everything seems to be going okay on the first build. So
now we're going to start with the CPU. This is part three of many parts to come. So we're going to start with the opening up box of the Intel chip. iCore 7. It's a 4.3, I think 4.1 megahertz system. It'll be overclock, so there's ways around it. So what I'm gonna do today, I'm gonna open it up, but I just want to talk about something about the box. First of all, the box is a tiny little box that you get now. Of course, paying like $300 or $400 for this sucker. I mean, you could get it cheaper in some other places. It's a seventh generation, of course, of Intel. Now, back in the days, Intel used to be a waste of paper and plastic. It used to come in a big old box, maybe this size. And they're actually doing something good for their environment now. They became smaller. They got a little smaller box with a high impact of a video CPU. I'm sorry. So kudos to Intel, you know, creating something small. It reminds me of back in the CD era when they used to have a big old box of CD, and then you just get a little tiny little solar system. So now it's a great step, and of course for a great VR experience. That's pretty much what everything's selling now these days, VR systems, because that's the next generation. We're going to talk about that in one of my shows, so stay tuned. And if you like this, give it a thumbs up. Core i7, Core 4, of course, and this is what you get when you open the box. But where are the instructions? There's one instruction manual right here. Now, before I commence with this system, I just wanted to let you know they give you something free besides the CPU. They give you a sticker. A sticker. So it's pretty much you put it in front of your computer saying, hey, look at me, I have a Core i7, 7th generation. Maybe you could steal it. So now you have this little tiny little CPU, of course, you know. And back then they used to put like the cement before. Now nothing's included. You got to get your own cement now. So I'm hoping that the fan that goes on top of this is included with this. So
I just want to demonstrate something here that you guys should be aware that the CPU has a little arrow in the corner that indicates the corner it belongs to. Now, if you go into your motherboard, you notice that there is no corner in here. So what you need to do is, before you begin, it tells you right there in the corner where to start the to match it up. So
now today I have something special that I'm going to include. This is part three or a build. NHD 15. It's going about under $100 on Amazon. Top pick. Great reviews. So we ended up getting that for our CPU. So let me unbox it for you right in front of you, because it's really, really neat. Back in the days when I was youngin', I used to work in UPS. One thing they used to teach you, UPS, pack them in, pack them right. Now this is what I call tie pack. This is a great, great, great set of pack. So right here, they give you all the tools you need, pretty much all the cables, even the cement that I was looking for and asking for, which is great. Now they do have little components part by part. Great to have. Screws. Ooh. what's in here? What is this? Now this is the piece of resistance. This is a big cooling fan system. And on top of it, of course, you have its own fan, empty box. So let's take a look at the fan first of all. The heat sink. And then I'm gonna try to open it up in here in front of you guys. Never opened it before. Oh my God, the radiator is just huge. I mean, this sucker is humongous. It's like the biggest CPU cooling fan I ever seen so far. And I can see why it's the top pick, because it's like a small little engine. Actually, they make engines smarter than this now these days. So there is a divider here. I'm gonna remove it slowly. And if you can see the components, the radiators, there's two radiators and there's a fan right in between the middle and the center. Now, it does have its own power supply. There's no cement included. Back in the days, they used to include cement. Now you have to include your own injection on it, because it turned out to be a mess back then, because once you put it in there, it's kind of hard to remove it and take a look at it. I can actually see the fan through. Great built, very sharp edges, so be careful. There's clips here to remove the fan in case you ever want to replace it with these neon LED lights fans. Great system to have, but this is the size of a little small one piston motor. It is huge. It's well built. There's a problem with the radiator fan. Now it seems like this part needs to go right underneath the motherboard. That causes a lot of situations. That means I gotta unscrew everything in here, put this right underneath, and secure it through the top, through the bottom actually. So we're gonna have to take a step back. Well, this part has to go underneath the motherboard, and it's a little struggle trying to get this in there. So you're gonna have to retake the motherboard off, which I just hate. I included this as a part three because usually the motherboard has the pins set up already, but in this case it doesn't. So we're gonna have to take off the motherboard and install it from the bottom to the top. In order to make the clearance here, you need to add these little plastic dividers. So once you place them in place, you gotta pretty much put this on top of the other and build something similar to what I'm doing right now. So these are tied in from the bottom, from the top and the bottom. So a little difficult to install this. Make sure to spread this compound cement all over the CPU. Once it squishes in there, it's gonna get every corner. So just make sure you get pretty much spread out if you can. They give you this much graded. So right before we mount the radiator, make sure you get this done first. Now the radiator has two pins right underneath, between here and here. And they go through each corner on every single side. As soon as you place it down in place, you make sure you tie on the screws. They have springs on them, so they're movable in case you're off by a couple of centimeters. Just a reminder, the tools included in the box fits through, it pushes in, and you screw it on. So you're pretty much set with this whole package deal. In order to place this radiator in the motherboard, you need to remove the actual fan that was in the center. So it's gonna be a little tough. A scale of hard, 1 through 5. I think this is gonna be like a 4. For those people who are trying to build their system, be careful not to damage anything in here, especially when you're working with the CPU. So you do need to remove the the vehicle, I mean the fan, and you need to place the embrace underneath the motherboard. So
make sure you connect the fan first before you install it. So this is the back fan, front fan, and the back fan.
There, it should look something like this. It should have a space even in it. So this fan's cooling the whole radiator. As you can see, a little difficult to install, but it's getting there. Pretty quiet system. Now that I installed the radiator and the fans, we have an issue.
It's gonna be a little hard trying to get back to the memory area, so you might want to add a memory included first before you mount the radiator. Or if you're one of those guys like me, just put it in there, dock it in, make sure you open up the braces, and then once you stick it in there, it should lock in automatically. It tells you that it's in. Start with the one in the back first before you commence.
These are Rip Jaws V. Feel the rush of the DDR4 performance. We're gonna be installing a 64 gigs of memory. So it's 16, 16, 32, 32, 64. Now, looking at the Ripjaws, pretty nice, fancy little memory chips that we have here. They have a little radiator right on top of it, so they can also cool down themselves. Very decent, well-made Ripjaws V DDR4. Power built. And here's the model number if you need to know. Some issues with this installation. I had to remove the fan, and I had to raise the radiator in order to put the last part of the memory in here, base. Very, very complicated with these parts. So
we set up the CPU underneath the radiator, the two fans, the four memory chips, which is very difficult. Scale 1 to 5. I gave it a 4 on the difficulty. Make sure that you're aware that the fans have to have some spacing in between, so make it easier for you.
Our continuing build. So today I have an 850 G2, 850 watts of power that's going to go into this tower. So I'm going to open it up so you can see what's included in this box. As you can see, it comes with a little pouch. It's like an Indiana Jones pouch. I guess you're going to be traveling a lot with this power source, or putting it, because once I install this power in these motherboard, in these towers, I don't intend to remove them ever until I get another upgrade or something. But this is the first I see. It's really unique. IVGA makes good products, good solid products. So including it, you get a power, of course, for the tower. Get all the cables that go along with all the motherboard. Get more cables for the CPU. More cables, CPU. How many CPUs are gonna run in this? VGA. And of course, here's a couple more power. You get tons of power that I'm not sure if you're gonna ever use these. They're pretty awesome too. They're has this nylon mesh. It surrounds every single cable. It looks nice and clean, very simple to plug and play. I like it so far, so good. Now, of course, they give you a couple of screws, and here's a big monster we gotta unwrap here. Of course, you get the manual right in front. And they wrap it up into this other extra mesh you could use as a little purse or bag, whatever you want. Oh, now I understand what the mesh for. This bag is for the extra cables that you're gonna have left over. So it makes sense to have a little bag in there. Now, this power, it's all built ready to go. every single plug comes in, it has its own setup here. On the side, you're going to see how many voltage, what's the voltage power, what's the output and the input, of course, and the big old monster fan, if you can see in here. It's a pretty awesome little device, of course. Not bad. 850 G2 from IVGA. Supernova. Gotta see how this product works. It's pretty heavy duty, so it's gonna be able to power my video card, the fans, and whatever else you have in there. Of course, all these new computers demand a lot of power, especially if you plan to install two video cards. Maybe you want to think about getting an 850. You want to run LED lights and push buttons where everything lights up. I mean, you're gonna need the power, so I recommend getting a big monster like this. It's not bad. There's also a little on and off eco switch in the back, I guess, to reduce the footprint. I guess you want to shut off or do a slow mode, or I guess throttle it down. I'm not sure what it is for. I'm gonna read more about it, but it looks really well made. It's well packed in here. Pretty sure they all have great instructions, but gotta see their reviews on there, and it seems like it was pretty high. That's why I ended up getting this IVGA 850 power source. So we're gonna save the best for last. This is not the last part, so I'm gonna jump a little ahead of the gun here and start opening up a couple of hard drives. So on this build that we're doing, we're gonna do a SATA solid state hard drive, the Samson 850 EVO. It's an SSD, of course. So this is gonna be the brains of the whole system, and this is gonna be just the OS part of it. So just keep in mind, these hard drives are very small and fragile, so but they could take a beating too. At the same time, you drop these suckers, they still survive, but just don't get them moist or wet or anything else. I mean, it's a chip, we're talking about memory. It's solid, there's no spinning wheels. It doesn't accumulate a lot of heat now. This is great to have, but you know, the higher number you get on the gigs, the more it's gonna cost you. This was a little price. I'll set up the price, how much I paid for and where to buy it. Like I said, it's 500 gigs. Really, really light, of course. And if you ever open one of these, it's just a chip in there. So it's just putting one of these memory cards into these little boxes and stacking them up and creating 500 gigs. The smaller these guys get, the USBs, the smaller these guys are gonna get too, and the more powerful. And the cost is gonna go down. So we're gonna start with this build and make this our OS component. And we have terabyte hard drives that just arrived too. These are not solid state, but they're also SATA connection. Oh, when I mean SATA connection, it has this little bridge here that you see. That's where we connect, you actually connect these to the motherboard. They started changing this back in 2001 or two, I guess, when they were start releasing them. I'm not sure about the history, but this is a much easier, better than the old-fashioned way where it had all these pins, you had to plug in everything in. If you bent one, it used to ruin the hard drives. Now I'm installing 2 terabytes, two terabytes on this system, so we could have all together 2,500 gigs of data that we can store in. Of course, these two hard drives are gonna be just for retaining files and documentations. And either we could do two directions with these hard drives. Either we can do RAID control them, either we could combine them together to become one, or you could keep them separate in the system. So basically what you're gonna have is 2 hard drives running your files, documentations. You can even install applications in here, and then you have your OS. So the reason this is a solid state drive, it's because the speeds are 10-20 times faster than this. This is actually spinning wheels in here that we have. So this accumulates a lot of heat on this. So this boots up pretty quick, pretty fast. It's digital, so basically it's like a USB. You plug it in, it comes up right away. You don't have to wait for a lot of to run any process, which is gonna run any a lot of processes. Again, don't get me wrong, it has the OS, so it takes maybe a couple seconds to boot up, but you'll see a big difference from this to this. So if I make this my OS, it would take a long time just trying to boot up. So it makes sense to make this your main OS and then have these just for file documentation or software installation too. So also included, we're gonna set up this drive. I didn't go fancy. I just ended up buying a writable DVD, DVD-R. They're really cheap. I think in the future, they're gonna be obsolete. The only reason I'm adding this is because it was requested. I paid, I think, $18 for this. And it's also SATA drive. So it's also has the same configurations as a motherboard that's gonna config with the video card, the motherboard, and these drives itself. So they all have the same similar connection. So this is fairly cheap and inexpensive. It has everything you need to do, but I think they're gonna be obsolete in a couple years. So enjoy your CV spinning. They accumulate a lot of heat too, that's why. And they take power. So that's why I don't think this format is gonna survive. Compared to what you can fit in one DVD, you probably fit on this 200 gig USB 10 times, 30 times more than what you fit on the DVD. So DVD 7 gigs, 256 gigs, you cannot beat it. So that's why I say the future is they're getting cheaper. At one point they used to be hundreds of dollars. Now you could probably find them under 10 bucks. $5 maybe the most. Really cheap material, but they don't spend too much material on these days. It's just a dying breed of hard work. So this is the package that I'm gonna include on this build that we're building here.